in Midday, Kentucky. We are here with Polly Singer, and she is the owner of Couture Hats and Veils. Mm-hmm. And welcome to the show, my friend.
Okay. Thank
Love
you.
The derby hats. These are so gorgeous.
Thank you so much.
It just
Thanks.
Totally puts me in the mood
in
for the
mood.
Derby. Yes, I love it. I love that you're here today. Thank you so much
yeah,
for joining
thank
us.
You for having
and
me.
I love my hat. Thank you.
Yeah.
I don't get to wear one of these very often, so hey,
yeah.
I'll take advantage of it when I can. Now, let's talk about how have Kentucky mm-hmm. derby styles mm-hmm. changed over the years? How have you seen
okay.
that?
Okay, well, actually, when I started designing, the hats were a lot smaller. They were actually smaller than this one here.
Uh-huh.
And over time, they've gotten bigger and bigger to where they're like this one now, the one I have on, the pink one.
Yeah.
And I think one of the reasons is people love to wear hats, but they don't have much of an opportunity.
Uh-huh.
So when they have the opportunity to finally do it, they just want to go big.
They just want to go for it. Yeah.
Well, and I understand that.
Exactly. And I mean, it's kind of the sign of the times,
exactly.
too, for society. So
exactly.
I love it. I love all the different styles. Now, let me ask you this.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about your fascinators.
Mm-hmm.
Are fascinators for younger women, or could they be for older women, too?
Okay. Actually, I think they're for both.
Yeah.
A lot of people are intimidated by fascinators.
Uh-huh.
They think that, you know, you have to be of a certain age or background to wear them, but I love them. And I think the most important thing is if you have the confidence to wear it and
yes.
you feel comfortable. To me, they're great because on Derby Day, a big hat, if we have bad weather, can get wet or
right,
ruin.
Right.
Something like this, it's really easy to take care of and it doesn't
mm-hmm.
get that wet. So.
Well, and it's very comfortable.
It
feels very secure. I've
exactly.
never had one on before, actually.
Yeah.
So this is the first time, and
oh,
I was
good.
Like, it's on there. Good.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah,
I like
uh-huh.
it. It's very comfortable. It doesn't
yeah.
pinch too tight
no,
or anything
exactly,
like that.
No, exactly.
So what are the type of hats that men typically mm-hmm. like? For
men,
women to wear.
It's actually really interesting. Men love the big hats.
Uh-huh.
They love the big hats. They love the curved brim. They love the very southern look.
Yes.
And I think it's a little romantic,
mm-hmm.
and it's just so different.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I find men respond to.
What are your inspirations for your designs
okay.
and for your hats?
Well, a lot of my inspirations are things like spring.
Okay.
Because after being in a cold Kentucky gray winter,
that's right.
I wanted to see some butterflies and bright colors.
Yes, I love the little butterflies
yeah,
on here. How cute is
people
that?
People love those. And then the lilies, and I do the lilies for the oaks.
Okay.
You know, Oaks Day, we have encouraged to wear pink.
Exactly.
So I do that.
Uh-huh.
And then really whimsical things, like this was one that a client wanted with horseshoes on it.
Mm-hmm.
And just something fun and outrageous.
Right.
So I kind of do whatever they tell me to do.
Now, how did you get started? Let's learn about something about your background as
okay.
far as how you got into making
well,
hats.
Actually, at the time I lived in New York, I was working in the music business.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Which I loved, and I was getting ready for work one day, and I'm not very good doing my hair, very well at doing my hair, so I got a hairbrush stuck in my hair,
oh, no.
and I had to cover it up, and it was July in New York City, so I had to wear a big purple crazy hat, and people responded to it. They were like, oh my God, I love that hat, that's so cool. So it kind of showed me that hats are fun and sculptural, and people react to them.
Yeah.
So
I mean, that could have went
yeah.
a totally different direction.
It could
you
have.
Could have like shaved your head off and started a whole new style trend
yeah,
with that,
I guess
instead
so.
You started into the hats.
I guess so.
That's fantastic. Now, what has been your most interesting and fascinating hat that you've had to design?
Oh, okay. Well, actually, I did something very similar to this years ago for Breeders' Cup. And the person wanted actual real horseshoes on
uh-huh.
because his dad was a farrier.
Yeah.
So she wanted real horseshoes. And that was such a challenge getting those heavy horseshoes
oh,
on
I
a
bet.
Hat. And it was heavy and they had to be welded together. So since then I found a suitable replacement. But just it was just so crazy and big and I get all kinds of funny requests.
Do you really?
Oh, yeah. Oh, over the years it's been kind of funny.
And
so.
Do you get
crazy.
Requests from all over the world?
Yeah. I have clients from all over the world. I do Ascot, I
mm-hmm.
do, you know, races on the West Coast and Ireland. So I have a worldwide clientele and following. So that's been fun.
That is fantastic.
Yeah.
Now this hat right here
mm-hmm.
is for a special occasion, right?
Yes. This one I designed for the Habitat for Humanity fundraiser in
okay.
Georgetown in April.
All right.
And I just wanted something bright and fun and colorful and they photograph so well too.
Yes, they
so,
do.
So I just kind of wanted an over the top hat for somebody.
Fantastic. Well, Polly, oh. thank you so much for being
thank
here.
You
we
for
really
having
appreciate
me.
It. We love your beautiful hats.
Thank
and
you.
And we are now going to toss to our wonderful music guest, Electria. Thank you very much for being here. Thank you.